We are all welcome in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Welcome to Home of God's Grace for widows and orphans. Agbowa Ikosi. My name is Grace Boluwajoko. I'm from Kwara State. This is we've already spent 24 years in this ministry. The Lord has been so faithful. When he says he wants to do something, nobody can say no. We have 22 graduates now. And we still have 12 undergraduates. So some of our children here has finished in UNILAG, Lagos State University, and Ado Ekiti University. To God be the glory. I met a man of God who saw me with this great body for children, and he promised to help me sponsor 60 out of these children from university. He has already helped me with 15 children that have graduated, and I'm still having 12 students in his university. He wouldn't like me to mention his name. So, to God be the glory for some people who came here and saw how helpless I am when they ask, how are you financing these children? I say it is by God's grace. So some people will say, okay, I will give your children, two of your children, a scholarship in secondary school. For example, two of them are now in Kusana High School in Ikorodu. And he promised that when this one, this two finish next year by the grace of God, she's going to get another one. So, this is how the Lord has been helping. I told you that this place is for widows and orphans. By the grace of God, tomorrow, Almighty God is going to feed 1,000 widows. Some people came from Lekki last week Saturday, and they fed 500 widows. Last year, under the lockdown, God fed 1,000. Even a man came with 1,000 tubers of yam in a big lorry. So these widows were given rice, beans, semo, spaghetti, salt, ororo, maggi. Whatever people donate, and some people will not even donate food. They will say, get this money and buy things for business. This is how the Lord has been doing. It's not because I have money that I started this ministry, but I had problem on my right nail. It was just swollen. I didn't know what happened, and I was treated like 2.5 years in Lut. by then I was dealing with school. So later they told me that I should go to Gobi. I went there. I was told to go to lab. When they tested me, they said that this thing is not TB or bones. I said, what is it? He said, no. I shouldn't worry. All the days, they gave me another letter back to Lut. On getting there, when they read it, he said, uh-huh. Grace, your leg is going to be amputated. I shook my head. Within me, I said, no. God who healed me of kidney damage for 12 years. When people thought I wouldn't be able to carry a pregnancy for 9 months, talk less of the day of delivery. It is only God who knows how my case is with Him. I'm special in His hand. I'm a mother of 5 with normal delivery. So when I remember all I went through, and somebody said this leg is going to be amputated, within myself I said, no, I will rather take my problem to God again. And I called the prayer warriors in our church, Equa Church in Tire, that this is what the doctor said. Oh, they said my leg is going to be amputated, and I reject it. Please, I need you people, come nearer. I believe in God that He is going to heal me without amputating my leg. And somebody said, you may believe, but what are you going to do for God? You always say you believe God can do it. God can do it. If He did this one, what are you going to do? I said, let that be between God and me. So he said, okay, it will only take 3 days, but it will be chain prayer. If I can get people who believe in prayer and who can pray very well. So I got people from Omedim, from Equa, my denomination, even from friends, and some friends from Baptist. And we had this Fiji. During this chain prayer, I told God that, Father, you have done it in the past. If you do this one, the rest of my life will be for you. Wherever you say I should go for the rest of my life, I'm ready. And whatever you say I should do, I will do it joyfully. So, between the last hour to complete 3 days prayer, there was no pain. But the swelling took about 2 weeks before it became, before my leg became normal. So after the healing now, God said, Grace, you said the rest of your life is for us. I said, yes. He now told me that there are younger widows than myself. Which were the widows? I was 54 when God called me. So, besides those who are younger than myself and they have small children, they don't have anything to care or cater for the children. I should now go to Agoa, rent a big house, so that if any young widow hear about me, they will come. When they bring their children, I should put the children in the school
And I should be teaching the mothers different kinds of skill. So, I was scared. Where will I get money? Okay, Father, if indeed you will be with me in this journey, I don't have money. My firstborn have just graduated there. He has not even served, talkless of getting a job. So I don't want to tell anybody that I want to start a ministry so somebody should borrow me money. No. And I don't want to begin to beg. So if you will deal with me, let me know right from the beginning. I was a dressmaker. If you can bless me from this my business, I will do the work.
But you got on condition. I love that.
Very yes, I bet you got on condition. So, you know, said he will help me. And when I get to Agbawa, I should acquire 10 acres of land. Father, at the age of 54, will I become a farmer? Is it more than to build a house and be living there? What will I use 10 acres for? He said, when it is time, I will know. Where will I get the money? He said, when it is time, I will get the money. Father, you said, if the widows want to remarry, and the husband is ready to help the children, they should go with their mama. But if the man will not help the children should stay with me. Hello? If they are many, and their mama has gone and married. What if these children are getting sick? I don't know how their mothers have been caring for them. He said I should go to Isaiah and Jeremiah 32:27, which says, behold, I am the God of all flesh. Is there anything impossible for me to do? I said, Father, I testify to it. There is nothing impossible for you to do. But what if the widows are many, their children are many, and we don't have something to eat? What will the widows do to me? He said, okay. I should go to Jeremiah 33:3. Yes. That call unto me, and I will answer you. And I will show you great and mighty things that you do not know. Right. So, that was what I held on to before the ministry started. I want to tell you that we are serving a covenant of Jesus. When we started the ministry, somebody had 2 acres of land behind our house. I got there. I asked the neighbors, who is the owner of this land? It's too bushy. Snake can come out and my children will be scared. Where is the person? He said, the person is not in Nigeria. Okay, can I clear it a bit? He said, sure. I started clearing it. As I was clearing it, I was planting something. Planting cassava, planting corn, planting vegetables. So, people didn't know that there was an orphanage in Agbawa for 10 years because there was no signboard. Inside, they called my area Okoroba. You So I began to clear this thing before the neighbors began to tell us, are you going to finish everything? Just to clear everything out so that snake will not. They said, this one is not than what are you? You think we don't know how to work? I don't say that. I should stop. Okay, I should stop. After some months, they didn't do anything. I began to clear again. So, some people from Ekwa who knew where I was, they used to come and visit. The gospel team of Ekwa, they used to come and visit. Gradually, Gideon International knew about this place because one of my board of trustees is one of the leaders in Gideon. So she told some women that there is a woman in Agbowa running an orphanage. This is our work. Let's go and visit her. From there, people begin to tell themselves. For 4 days, we were unable to get beans. And we loved beans very much. No money to buy. On the fourth day, happened to be a Friday. I called my children, please go to school. When you come back, we will break our fast. In the evening today, we are going to have Fiji. You will see what is going to happen on Saturday morning. We will start eating beans. Ah, they were happy. So we had Fiji. We praised God for 3 hours without asking anything. So when we want to start, children, I want you to appreciate God again. Now, this is 3:15 a.m. Tell God that, Father Lord, whosoever you have sent to come and give us either money or this. And they said that Baba is too far. It's next week when we go. It's next tomorrow. Father, in the name of Jesus, it's no more tomorrow. It's this morning, this Saturday morning, we want to eat beans. We want to eat beans in the name of Jesus. Before 11 o'clock, the house was full of beans, rice. Even for the first time, somebody brought us 40 pieces of smoked fish. For the first time, So that was the first miracle God did. There was a time I wanted to take 2 of my children to eye clinic. No money to fuel the car. In the evening, we had them playing up. So I told them in the hall, children, I want to take 2 of you to the eye clinic tomorrow. But no money to fuel the car. I will get there before 9 o'clock. So, my children, let's pray. We prayed. In the midnight, I got up. Father, the day was hungry. How are you going to do it? All I know is that you have never disappointed me. So I want to get there before 9. Father, whosoever you said, let the person come on time so that these children will be attended to. By 6 a.m., we were here, praising God, clapping our hands, dancing before the Lord. By 6 o'clock, somebody was at the gate, knocking to bless. called when we didn't hear the drumming again. By then I was reading Bible to the children. So he called me. I didn't even look who was calling. I just off my phone, continue reading the Bible. He was there for 45 minutes. Somebody who was rushing to office, he was there. So as soon as we finished by 6:45, I put on my phone. Then my daughter called me at the gate. Now somebody said he is at the gate. Open the gate, Mama. I called somebody. Oh yeah, go and open the gate. The person said, I came. Okay, please. Don't be annoyed. We were having our morning. He said, Mama, it's too early. I wouldn't get biscuit to buy, but just get this buy biscuit for them. I took it, I held it. I prayed for him. As soon as he turned like this, I opened my own. What it all? 1,000. Driver! Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Before 9 o'clock, I went to the house. Another time, I want to buy a bottle of palm oil for only 100 naira. There was no 100 naira. And the children want to buy bread. That one cost me 200. Children have many things at home. I will cook a delicious food for you tomorrow morning. But this bread has to go. Children, go and bring all the empty heads of palm oil. Drain it. You are able to eat in the afternoon. No hope for eating. Children, you have eaten up. Oh, yeah, go and sleep. I want to have my quiet time. Nobody to come and know. You said okay. I wasn't up an hour on my knees before I had breathing. I put the hand up my prayer. The person said, "Where is your grandma?" The boy said, "Grandma is inside, but." He didn't let him finish what he wanted to say. Boy, come and carry your loads. Which load from the boy of 7 carry? The first thing that person brought was a head of palm oil containing 25 liters.
Wow.
If I should continue telling you about the goodness, I know you have places to go. So, all I want to say is that we are serving a covenant-keeping God. We are serving a living God. A covenant-keeping God. When I was crying, that how can people just gather their children with me and go and remarry? What if the children are sick? It was then he said, behold, I am the God of all flesh. Is there anything impossible for me to do? There is nothing impossible for me to do. And I want to tell you, for the first 10 years that I started this ministry, none of these children was sick. So as to say, we are going to pass blood or water. And after 3 days, if the temperature is not, it's still on. Okay, let's go to the hospital. And you say, what we say, Grandma, you prayed for that person, you didn't go to the hospital. Pray for me too. The Lord has given us. We are serving a covenant people. I don't know among you. God has been telling you together. He said to me, but he told me, I should tell two people.
Hello?
Church.
One. Hello.
Was an elder. Another one. Now, I am a pastor. And I should tell them that I wanted to be so very bold. I didn't want to tell the elder, because in his factory by then, every January, I get money to settle my children when I sew overall coat for his workers. He was a printer, printing cards. So, I didn't want to tell him. I wanted to settle down in Agbawa before I will now tell you. But the first person, the pastor whom I went to, that God said, I should tell you, I wanted to live soon later for Agbawa. He said, Mrs. Bogudoku. By then, I was Mrs. Bogudoku. It was after 4 years that I saw the tremendous things Almighty God had been doing, and he's still doing it. I changed my name from Bogudoku to Bogudoku. And I know he's moving himself.
Thank you very much, ma. If we really allow you to continue, I know we won't leave here till tomorrow. My name is Fola Odoseya. I'm the founder and keeper of Omedim. Omedim means Omo Epe Division Movement. So we are trying to bring everybody in Epe Division together, both home and abroad, so that we can foster love and unity and assist the less privileged, and to do any other thing that can assist us as a division. So, actually, this is our first time of donating to an orphanage officially. So, and when we got here, and with little we heard from you, we are highly impressed, and you have even encouraged me to push further. And actually, if I tell you how Omedim came to stand, it will take a very long time. Because the day I made up my mind, I'm going to close up this Omedim, that I was no more interested. That was the day he showed me the way. Each time I wanted to go back, I always see the signs that I should not go back, that there's a reason for creating Omedim. A lot has happened that even me have lost hope. That one way or the other, things will bounce back. So, and I'm learning a lot from you now. God is alive. And God is
alive.
God is doing wonderful things.
Yes.
So we are so happy. This is very small. But by next year, we are coming here with truck. That is the way I want God to
be.
Amen.
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 So these are just some of our people. We have over 30,000 members all over the world. We have in diasporas, we have here. But you know, things like this, most of the time, it's not easy for people to donate money. But the little we can gather together, that is what we have brought. But I'm saying it, and I'm repeating it, by next year, we are coming here with truck full of loads for the
children
and for the widows. And for everyone that wishes to help you, God will provide for them, and God will provide for people to help my own ministry.
Amen.
And everyone that stands by me, God will stand by them.
Amen.
So, we really appreciate you. My name is Honoré Fola Onosoya once again. This is Mr. Olusegun Olutade Yeye Oge Keji Miriam. That is Mrs. Agbuola Mama Omedi. This is Mrs. Madojutola, and that is Mrs. Selnot. So we are very happy, and we shall continue to come back. And things that will make us to come back, God will provide it for us.
So,
thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, ma'am. You are people, you are wonderful. Let me tell you something about youth in Epe. Some children gather themselves together. Some of them have not got admission. Some of them are still in secondary school, like SS3. And they were about 15. They came one day, and the paper they gave me, as they brought your own now. They call themselves the generation shaker. Generation shaker. Let me quickly and go and see the generation shaker. Then I saw generation shaker. As you call yourself, so will it be in the name of Jesus. You will shake generations. So be a meta, Martin, and your mama interpret you, Emma David Agbara Olorun. Emma David Agbara Olorun. You know my generation shaker muwa. One more guy, Jewa. One more Ewa Jewa. A de ti gbadura laaro ojo yen pe ko si gari ko se wa o eyin omo e gbadura o ti je pe ewa ti won mu wa ko lo eyan marun and we are more than 65 o ti je pe gari yen o yo eyan meta o ko ba de ko ba so fun de pe mama awon mo ni o je nkan to lo school a de ri mota emergency ti mo gbe yen fun awon ma ikoko mu gari na so maybe you just read the at the 1 year. I saw you want more. What you want to see? No, Ghana must go. I want to do more. You want to see? No, Ghana must go. On the opportunity, one sachet of Milo, only 400 milligrams. At the Dano, they just need more. Lori, you wait at the exercise books. Pencil. And viral, so I call him. I want any more. Are you people from Epe? You are great. Nobody or your Sunday. Bobo Ali, she come and give you testimony. You mobile and give you testimony. And your mother, Sinibi, in the year 2005. Who got answer of where near Wale? Tan pari wo pe baba fe je wa to wa pese ewa to wa pese ju n ta bere lo be ba wa ni tojo yen e wa re leyi si a gbadura lana by 7 o'clock ka go mesan to lu awon generation shaker won wa lati epe won de mu ewa ati dariwa gbogbo won ba patewo won ni bo ti e je pe koto eyan le lo kan je ṣugbọn eyan ade le wa won ari nkan mo jade ani na niyan awon kan de ma wa ki wa once in a month on Sunday bi won se ba oro yen ni enu mi ni na wa ni mama so eni de wa ti gari bayi e ko mu ni Wednesday am ara apoko kan wa fun yin la won omo mi ba ton patewo ka to pari service ni oko ba ni mama ejo e fun mi ni account number olorun so pe agudo ma mo owo yen le leni
business ko di rira lojo yen
ka to lo awon de ma gbe mi lo si imota si ka lo
ra
oluwa
ba sha
se ba se ra ewa ba se ra gari ni o wa di Tuesday
woni
eni ka ko bu do ya
ki kemi o
yen ni igba ti awon
lockdown we can start
Wednesday,
any couple here,
daddy.
You are coming one Wednesday, a lot of work for you. So, when you tell my dear friend, starting, I want to provide
you. Young people from Epe, you are great.
Thank you, ma'am.
And you will continue to be great.
Amen.
In the mighty name of
Jesus. Amen.
You put new world, you know.
Amen.
And new world, you know.
Amen.
has been not done.
Amen.
Let's stop video. Yeah, yeah.